chapter on clarification that the chain of narration is part of the religion, and reports should only be narrated from those who are trustworthy, and the critical assessment and evaluation of narrators for things that are true is permissible and is in fact obligatory, and that doing so is not backbiting, that is forbidden. Rather, it is defending the honorable Sharia. It was narrated that Muhammad bin Sirin said, "This knowledge is the foundation of religion, so watch from whom you learn your religion." It was narrated that Ibn Sirin said, "They used not to ask about chains of narration, but when the fitna occurred, they said, 'Tell us about your men in the chain of narration.' They would look for the people of Sunnah in them to accept their hadith, and they would look for the people of Bid'ah in them to reject their hadith." It was narrated that Sulaiman bin Musa said, "I met Tawus and said, 'So-and-so narrated such and such to me.' He said, 'If your companion is Malian, able, then learn from him.'" Footnote: Malian means trustworthy, precise, and reliable, firm in his religion and his understanding, like one who would be relied upon to collect wealth. Sa'id bin Abdul Aziz said, "It was narrated that Sulaiman bin Musa said, 'I said to Tawus, so-and-so narrated such and such to me.' He said, 'If your companion is Malian, able, then learn from him.'" It was narrated from Ibn Abi Zinad that his father said, "In Al-Madinah, I met 100 men, all of whom were reliable, but no one accepted a hadith from them. It was said, 'He is not one of its people.'" Footnote: the statement, "He is not one of its people," means he has no knowledge of this field. It was narrated that Mis'ar said, "I heard Sa'd bin Ibrahim say, 'There is to be no narrating from the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, except from those who are trustworthy.'" Footnote: except from those who are trustworthy means the narrations attributed to Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, are not accepted but from the trustworthy. Muhammad bin Abdullah bin Quhzada, from the people of Marwa, narrated to me, he said, "I heard Abdan bin Uthman saying, 'Abdullah bin al-Mubarak said, the chain of narration is part of religion. Were it not for the chain, anyone could say whatever he wanted.' He, Muslim, said, 'Muhammad bin Abdullah said, Al-Abbas bin Abi Rizma said to me, I heard Abdullah say, the criterion between us and other people is these lists,' meaning the chain of narration. Muhammad said, 'I heard Abu Ishaq Ibrahim bin Isa al-Taliqani say, I said to Abdullah bin al-Mubarak, O Abu Abdurrahman, there is a hadith which says, it is part of honoring one's parents in death, after honoring them in life, to pray on behalf of your parents when you pray, and fast on behalf of your parents when you fast.' Abdullah said, O Abu Ishaq, from whom did you get this?" I said to him, "This hadith is from Shihab bin Khirash." He said, "He is trustworthy. From whom did he get it?" I said, "From al-Hajjaj bin Dinar." He said, "He is trustworthy. From whom did he get it?" I said, "The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him." He said, "O Abu Ishaq, between al-Hajjaj bin Dinar and the Prophet, peace be upon him, there is a big gap which cannot be easily bridged, but there is no dispute concerning charity given on behalf of deceased parents." Muhammad said, "I heard Ali bin Shaqiq say, I heard Abdullah bin al-Mubarak say, in front of the people, ignore the ahadith of Amir bin Thabit, for he used to verbally abuse the Salaf." It was narrated that Abu Aqil, the companion of Buhayya, said, "I was sitting with Al-Qasim bin Ubaidillah and Yahya bin Sa'id. Yahya said to Al-Qasim, O Abu Muhammad, how grave is it for a great man like you to be asked a question about this religion, and you have no knowledge of it, and no answer? Al-Qasim said to him, Why is that? He said, Because you are the son of two imams of guidance, the son of Abu Bakr and Umar. Al-Qasim said to him, What is worse than that is one who knows about Allah but speaks without knowledge, or accepts a report from one who is not trustworthy. He fell silent and did not answer him. Footnote: Buhayya was a freed slave, and his name is Yahya bin al-Mutawakkil. It was narrated by Sufyan bin Uyayna, who said, They informed me about Abu Aqil, the companion of Buhayya, that a son of Abdullah bin Umar was asked about something of which he did not have any knowledge. Yahya bin Sa'id said to him, I feel it is very grave that a man like you, who is the son of two imams of guidance, meaning Umar and Ibn Umar, can be asked about something of which he has no knowledge. He said, By Allah, it is more serious than that before Allah and before anyone who has any knowledge of Allah, to speak without knowledge, or to narrate from someone who is not trustworthy. Abu Aqid, Yahya ibn al-Mutawakkil, was present while the two of them said that. It was narrated that Yahya bin Sa'id said, I asked Sufyan al-Thawri, Shu'bah, Malik, and Ibn Uyayna about a man who was not reliable in narration of hadith, but a man came and asked me about him. They said, Tell them that he is not reliable. It was narrated that an-Nadhr said, While Ibn Aun was standing in the threshold, he was asked about the hadith of Shahar. He said, They condemned Shahar. They condemned Shahar. Abu al-Husayn, Muslim bin al-Hajjaj, may Allah have mercy on him, said, Ibn Aun meant that the people have taken to criticizing him. Footnote: The statement, standing in the threshold, means he was standing in the opening of either a door or a gate. It was narrated that Shu'bah said, I met Shahr, but I did not pay any attention to him. Muhammad bin Abdullah bin Quhzada, from the people of Marwa, narrated to me, he said, Ali bin Hussein bin Waqid said, Abdullah bin al-Mubarak said, I said to Sufyan al-Thawri, Abbad bin Kathir is one whose situation you know about. When he narrates a report, he makes serious mistakes. Do you think that I should tell the people not to accept reports from him? Sufyan said, Yes. Abdullah said, If I was in a gathering where mention was made of Abbad, I would praise him for his religion, but I would say, Do not accept reports from him. Muhammad narrated to us, Abdullah bin Uthman said, My father said, Abdullah bin al-Mubarak said, I went to Shu'bah, and he said, This is Abbad bin Kathir. Be aware of him. Al-Fadl bin Sahal narrated to me, I asked Mu'alla al-Razi about Muhammad bin Sa'id, the one that Abbad bin Kathir narrated from. So he told me that Isa bin Yunus said, I was at his door, and Sufyan was with him. When he came out, I asked him about Muhammad bin Sa'id, and he told me that he was a liar. It was narrated from Muhammad bin Yahya bin Sa'id al-Qattan that his father said, We have not seen any fault in the righteous worse than their telling lies in narrating hadith. Ibn Abi Attab said, I met Muhammad bin Yahya bin Sa'id al-Qattan, and I asked him about him. He said, Narrating from his father, you will not see in good people anything worse than in telling lies about hadith. Muslim said, This means lies flow from their tongues, but they do not lie deliberately. It was narrated that Khalifa bin Musa said, I entered upon Ghalib bin Ubaidillah, and he started to dictate to me. Makhul narrated to me. Then he needed to urinate, so he got up, and I looked at his notebook and in it was written, Abban narrated to me from Anas. Abban narrated from so-and-so, so I got up and left. He, Muslim, said, And I heard Al-Hasan bin Ali Al-Hulwani say, I saw in the book of Affan a hadith of Hisham Abu al-Miqdad, a hadith of Umar bin Abdul Aziz. Hisham said, A man called Yahya bin so-and-so narrated to me from Muhammad bin Ka'b. I said to Affan, They say that Hisham heard it from Muhammad bin Ka'b. He said, His problem started with this hadith. He used to say, Yahya narrated to me from Muhammad. Then after that, he claimed that he had heard it from Muhammad. Muhammad bin Abdullah bin Quhzada narrated to me, I heard Abdullah bin Uthman bin Jabalah saying, I said to Abdullah bin al-Mubarak, Who is the man from whom you narrated the hadith of Abdullah bin Amr? The day of Al-Fitr is the day of rewards. He said, Sulaiman bin al-Hajjaj. Look into what you get from him. Ibn Quhzada said, I heard Wahab bin Zam'a mentioning from Sufyan bin Abdul Malik, who said, Abdullah, meaning Ibn al-Mubarak, said, I saw Rawh bin Qutayf, the narrator of the hadith about blood the size of a dirham, and I sat with him for a while, but I began to feel embarrassed of my companions if they were to see me with him, because they disliked his narrations. Footnote. The statement, blood the size of a dirham, means prayer is to be repeated if there is a blood stain the size of a dirham. It was recorded by Ad-Darqutini in his Sunan, Al-Bayhaqi in his Sunan, and Al-Uqayli in Ad-Du'affa. It was narrated that Abdullah bin al-Mubarak said, Baqiyya is truthful in speech, but he accepts reports from anyone. It was narrated that Al-Sha'bi said, Al-Harith al-A'war al-Hamdani narrated to me, but he was a liar. It was narrated that Mughira said, I heard Al-Sha'bi say, Al-Harith al-A'war narrated to me, but he bears witness that Al-Harith al-A'war is one of the liars. It was narrated that Ibrahim said, Al-Qama said, I read the Qur'an in 2 years. Al-Harith said, The Qur'an is easy, but the Wahi, revelation, is more difficult. It was narrated from Ibrahim that Al-Harith said, I learned the Qur'an in 3 years, and the Wahi in 2. Or he said, The Wahi in 3 years, and the Qur'an in 2. It was narrated from Ibrahim that Al-Harith was accused of fabrication. It was narrated that Hamza al-Zayyat said, Murra al-Hamdani heard something from al-Harith, and he said to him, Sit by the door. Murra went in and picked up his sword, but al-Harith sensed that he was up to no good, so he went away. It was narrated that Ibn Aun said, Ibrahim said to us, Be aware of Al-Mughira bin Sa'id and Abu Abdul Rahim, for they are liars. It was narrated that Asim said, We used to go to Abu Abdul Rahman al-Sulaymi when we were young boys, and he used to say to us, Do not sit with the storytellers except for Abu al-Ahwas, and be aware of Shaqiq. And he said, This Shaqiq held some Khariji views, but he was not Abu Wa'il. Abu Ghassan Muhammad bin Amr al-Razi narrated to us. He said, I heard Jarir say, I met Jabir bin Yazid al-Ju'fi, but I did not write down anything from him, as he believed in al-Raj'ah. Footnote, al-Raj'ah means the return to this life after death, reincarnation, and before the Day of Judgment. It is either regarding Ali, may Allah be pleased with him, or the Shia claim that the Mahdi is alive and shall return. It was narrated that Mis'ar said, Jabir bin Yazid narrated to us before he innovated as he did. It was narrated that Sufyan said, the people used to narrate from Jabir before he showed what he showed, and when he showed what he showed, the people suspected his hadith, and some people abandoned him. It was said to him, what did he show? He said, belief in al-Raj'ah, return to this life, after death, and before the day of judgment.
It was narrated that Abu Yahya al-Himmani said, Qabisa and his brother narrated us that they heard al-Jarrah bin Malih say, I heard Jabir bin Yazid say, I have 70,000 ahadith, all from Abu Ja'far, from the Prophet, peace be upon him. It was narrated that Zuhair said, Jabir said, or I heard Jabir say, I have 50,000 ahadith, and I have not narrated any of them. Then one day he narrated a hadith and said, this is one of the 50,000. It was narrated that Salam bin Abi Muti'a said, I heard Jabir al-Ju'fi say, I have 50,000 hadith from the Prophet, peace be upon him. Sufyan said, I heard a man asking Jabir about the verse of the Holy Quran, therefore I will not leave this land until my father permits me, or Allah decides my case, and he is the best of the judges. Jabir said, this has not been fulfilled yet. Sufyan said, he is lying. We said to Sufyan, what did he mean by that? He said, the Rafida say that Ali is in the clouds, and we will not join any of his sons who rebel against the state, until a voice calls out to us from heaven, meaning Ali, who will tell us to go out and support so-and-so. Jabir said, this is the interpretation of this verse, but he was lying. It was about the brothers of Yusuf, peace be upon him. Footnote, the verse, therefore, I will not leave this land until my father permits me, or Allah decides my case, and he is the best of the judges, is from Surah Yusuf, chapter 12, verse 80. It was narrated that Sufyan said, I heard Jabir narrating nearly 30,000 ahadith, but I would not allow myself to mention any of them, even if I had such and such. Muslim said, I heard Abu Ghassan Muhammad bin Amr al-Razi say, I asked Jarir bin Abdul Hamid, did you meet al-Harith bin Hasira? He said, yes, he was a very quiet old man who was hiding something serious. It was narrated that Hamad bin Zayd said, Ayyub mentioned a man one day and said, he is not careful about what he says. And he mentioned another, and said, he adds to the number. Footnote, the statement, he adds to the number, means, he exaggerates, telling lies, like the merchant who lies about the price he paid for the goods he is selling. It was narrated that Hamad bin Zayd said, Ayyub said, I have a neighbor. Then he mentioned some of his virtues. Then he said, but if he were to testify before me even concerning two date fruits, I would not find his testimony acceptable. It was narrated that Ma'mar said, I never saw Ayyub backbite about anyone except Abdul Karim, meaning Abu Umayyah. He mentioned him and said, may Allah have mercy on him. He was not trustworthy, and he asked me about a hadith of Ikrimah. Then he said, I heard Ikrimah. It was narrated that Hammam said, Abu Dawood al-A'ma came to us and started saying, Al-Bara narrated to us, and Zayd bin Arqam narrated to us. We mentioned that to Qatada, and he said, he is lying. He never heard anything from them. Rather, he used to beg from the people at the time of the severe plague. It was narrated that Hammam said, Abu Dawood al-A'ma entered upon Qatada, and when he left, they said, "This man claims that he met 18 men who had been present at the battle at Badr." Qatada said, "He used to beg before the plague, and he has nothing to do with that at all, and he should not speak. By Allah, Al-Hasan did not narrate directly from anyone who had been present at Badr, and Sa'id bin al-Musayyab did not narrate directly from anyone who had been present at Badr, except for Sa'd bin Malik." It was narrated from Raqaba that Abu Ja'far al-Hashimi al-Madani used to fabricate hadith, though the words were true, but they were not a hadith from the Prophet, peace be upon him. But he used to report that they were from the Prophet, peace be upon him. It was narrated that Shu'bah narrated from Yunus bin Ubaid, who said, "Amr bin Ubaid used to tell lies in hadith." It was narrated that Mu'adh bin Mu'adh said, "I said to Auf bin al-Jamila that Amr bin Ubaid narrated to us from al-Hasan that the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, 'Whoever bears weapons against us is not one of us.' He said, 'Amr is lying, by Allah,' but he wanted to use that to support his vile views." Footnote. See Hadith number 280. The censure is regarding his claim that he heard it from al-Hasan, not regarding the hadith itself. It was narrated that Hammad bin Zayd said, "A man had been staying close to Ayyub and listening to him. Then Ayyub noticed that he was missing. They said to him, 'O Abu Bakr, now he is staying close to Amr bin Ubaid.' Hammad said, 'One day while I was with Ayyub and we had gone early to the market, he met that man. Ayyub greeted him with salam and asked him. Then Ayyub said to him, "I have heard that you are staying close to that man." Hammad asked, "Did he name him?" meaning Amr. He said, "Yes, O Abu Bakr, he tells us weird things." Ayyub said to him, "We run away from, or we feel anxious about those weird things." It was narrated that Ibn Zayd, meaning Hammad, said, "It was said to Ayyub that Amr bin Ubaid narrated that Al-Hasan said, 'The drunkard is not to be flogged if he is intoxicated by consuming nabith.' He said, 'He is lying. I heard Al-Hasan say that the drunkard is to be flogged for drinking nabith.'" It was narrated that Salam bin Abi Muti' said, "Ayyub heard that I was going to Amr, so he came to me one day and said, 'If you are not safe with his religion, how can you be safe with his ahadith?'" It was narrated that Sufyan said, "I heard Abu Musa say, 'Amr bin Ubaid narrated to us before he innovated.'" Ubaidillah bin Mu'adh al-Anbari narrated to me, "My father narrated us. I wrote to Shu'bah asking him about Abu Shaybah, the Qadi of Wasit. He wrote to me saying, 'Do not write down anything from him and tear up my letter.'" Al-Hulwani narrated to me, he said, "I heard Affan say, 'I told Hammad bin Salama a hadith from Salih al-Murri, from Thabit. He said, "He is lying." And I told Hammam a hadith from Salih al-Murri, and he said, "He is lying." Abu Dawood said, "Shu'bah said to me, 'Go to Jarir bin Hazim and tell him, it is not permissible for you to narrate from al-Hasan bin Umarah, because he tells lies.'" Abu Dawood said, "I said to Shu'bah, 'How is that?' He said, 'He narrated to us from al-Hakam things for which I find no basis.' He said, 'I said to him, what things?' He said, 'I asked al-Hakam, did the Prophet, peace be upon him, offer the funeral prayer for those who were slain at Uhud, he said, he did not offer the prayer for them. But Al-Hasan bin Umara said, narrating from Al-Hakam, from Miqsam, from Ibn Abbas, that the Prophet, peace be upon him, offered the prayer for them and buried them. I said to Al-Hakam, what do you say about the children of zina, children born out of wedlock? He said, the funeral prayer should be offered for them. I said, from the hadith of whom is that narrated? He said, it is narrated from Al-Hasan Al-Basri. But Al-Hasan bin Umara said, Al-Hakam narrated to us from Yahya bin Al-Jazzar, from Ali, may Allah be pleased with him. Al-Hasan Al-Hulwani narrated to me, he said, I heard Yazid bin Harun, when he mentioned Ziyad bin Maymun, say, I swore that I would not narrate anything from him, or from Khalid bin Mahduj. He said, I met Ziyad bin Maymun, and I asked him about a hadith. He narrated it to me from Bakr al-Muzani. Then I went back to him, and he narrated it to me from Muwarriq. Then I went back to him, and he narrated it to me from Al-Hasan, and he used to accuse the two of them of lying. Al-Hulwani said, I heard Abdus Samad, when I mentioned Ziyad bin Maymun in his presence, accuse him of lying. Mahmud bin Ghaylan narrated to me, he said, I said to Abu Dawood, Al-Tayalisi, you have narrated a great deal from Abbad bin Mansur. How come you did not hear from him the hadith of Al-Attara, which was narrated to us by Al-Nadr bin Shumail? He said to me, be quiet. Abdurrahman bin Mahdi and I met Ziyad bin Maymun and we asked him. We said to him, what are these ahadith that you narrate from Anas? He said, what do you think of a man who commits a sin then repents? Doesn't Allah accept his repentance? We said, yes. He said, I did not hear either a little or a lot from Anas, meaning nothing at all. If the people do not know, then you now know that I did not meet Anas. Abu Dawood said, after that, I heard that he was narrating and Abdurrahman and I went to him and he said, I repent. Then after that, he was narrating again. So we ignored him. Hasan al-Hulwani narrated to me. He said, I heard Shababa say, Abdul Quddus used to narrate to us and say, Suwayd bin Aqala. Shababa said, and I heard Abdul Quddus say, the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, forbade using Ar-Rawhu Ardan. It was said to him, what does that mean? He said, it means making a small window in a wall to let the breeze pass through. Muslim said, I heard Ubaidillah bin Umar al-Qawariri say, I heard Hamad bin Zayd say to a man, a few days after Mahdi bin Hilal arrived, what is this tainted spring coming from your direction? He said, yes indeed, O Abu Ismail. Footnotes. 1. The name Suwayd bin Aqalah is mentioned by Abdul Quddus, while the name is Suwayd bin Ghaflah. 2. Regarding the statement, Ar-Rawhu Ardan, the issue here has to do with the phrase, يُتَّخَذَ الرَّوْحُ غَرْضًا, taking a living creature as a target, which is the correct wording of the narration. However, it was misread and recited by Abdul Quddus as, يُتَّخَذَ الرَّوْحُ عَرْضًا, making a space to let the air in. Both of these examples were mentioned to demonstrate his lack of abilities as a narrator. 3. The statement, what is this tainted spring coming from your direction, means that he felt he was weak and not fit to narrate hadith. Al-Hasan al-Hulwani narrated to me, he said, I heard Affan say, I heard Abu Awana say, no hadith reached me from Al-Hasan but I bring it to Abban bin Abi Ayyash, and he would recite it for me. Suwayd bin Sa'id narrated to me. He said, Ali bin Mushir narrated to us, Hamza al-Zayyat and I heard approximately 1,000 ahadith from Abban bin Abi Ayyash. Ali said, I met Hamza and he told me that he saw the Prophet, peace be upon him, in a dream, and he told him what he had heard from Abban, and he did not recognize anything except a few things, 5 or 6. Zakariya bin Adi said, Abu Ishaq al-Fazari said to me, write down from Baqiyya whatever he narrates from those who are known, and do not write down what he narrates from those who are not known, and do not write down anything that Ismail bin Ayyash narrated from those who are known, nor those who are not known. Ishaq bin Ibrahim al-Hanzali narrated to me, he said, I heard some of the companions of Abdullah say, Ibn al-Mubarak said, what a good man Baqiyya would be, were it not that he changes names into nicknames, and nicknames into names. For a long time, he used to narrate to us from Abu Sa'id al-Wuhadhi. Then we realized that that was Abdul Quddus. Ahmed bin Yusuf al-Azdi narrated to me. He said, I heard Abdul Razzaq say, I never saw Ibn al-Mubarak state bluntly that anyone was a liar, except in the case of Abdul Quddus. I heard him say, he is a liar. Abdullah bin Abdurrahman al-Darimi narrated to me. He said, I heard Abu Nu'aym say, and he mentioned al-Mu'alla bin Urfan. He said, Abu Wa'il narrated to us, Ibn Mas'ud came out to us at the Battle of Siffin. Abu Nu'aym said, do you think that he was resurrected after death? It was narrated that Affan bin Muslim said, we were with Ismail bin Ulayya, and a man narrated a report from another man. I said that this one is not reliable. The man said, you are backbiting about him. Ismail said, he is not backbiting. Rather, he judged that he is not reliable. Bishr bin Umar said, I asked Malik bin Anas about Muhammad bin Abdurrahman, who narrated from Sa'id bin al-Musayyab. He said, he is not trustworthy. I asked Malik bin Anas about Abu al-Huwayrith. He said, he is not trustworthy. I asked him about Shu'bah, from whom Ibn Abi Dhi'b narrated. He said, he is not trustworthy. I asked him about Salih, the freed slave of At-Tawamah. He said, he is not trustworthy. I asked him about Haram bin Uthman. He said, he is not trustworthy. I asked Malik about these 5. He said, they are not trustworthy in their ahadith. I asked him about another man whose name I have forgotten, and he said, have you seen him in my books? I said, no. He said, if he were trustworthy, you would have seen him in my books. Al-Fadl bin Sahal narrated to me. He said, Yahya bin Ma'in narrated to me. Hajjaj narrated to us. Ibn Abi Dhi'b narrated to us. From Shurahbil bin Sa'ad. And he was accused. Muhammad bin Abdullah bin Quhzada narrated to me. He said, I heard Abu Ishaq al-Talaqani say, I heard Ibn al-Mubarak say, if I had been given the choice between entering paradise and meeting Abdullah bin Muharrar, I would have chosen to meet him, then enter paradise. But when I did see him, I realized that camel dung was dearer to me than him. Al-Fadl bin Sahal narrated to me. Walid bin Salih narrated to us. Ubaidillah bin Amr said, Zayd, meaning Ibn Abi Unaysa, said, do not accept any reports from my brother. Ahmed bin Ibrahim al-Dawraqi
narrated to me, he said, Abdus Salam al-Wabisi told me, Abdullah bin Ja'far al-Raqi narrated to me, that Ubaydillah bin Amr said, Yahya bin Abi Unaysa was a liar. Ahmed bin Ibrahim narrated to me, he said, Sulaiman bin Harb narrated to me, that Hamad bin Zayd said, mention of Farqad was made in the presence of Ayyub, and he said, Farqad is not a person of Hadith. Abdurrahman bin Bishr al-Abdi narrated to me, he said, I heard Yahya bin Sa'id al-Qattan say, when mention was made in his presence of Muhammad bin Abdullah bin Ubaid bin Umair al-Laythi, that he was very weak in narration, it was said to Yahya, weaker than Ya'qub bin Ata'a? He said, yes. Then he said, I did not think that anyone would narrate from Muhammad bin Abdullah bin Ubaid bin Umair. Bishr bin Hakam narrated to me, he said, I heard Yahya bin Sa'id al-Qattan describe Hakim bin Jubair, Abdul A'la and Yahya bin Musa bin Dinar as weak in narration. He said, his hadith is nothing, and he classed Musa bin Dihqan and Isa bin Abi Isa al-Madini as weak. And I heard al-Hasan bin Isa say, Ibn al-Mubarak said to me, when you come to Jarir, write down all of his knowledge, except for reports from three people. Do not write down from him reports from Ubaidah bin Mu'attib, As-Sari bin Ismail, and Muhammad bin Salim. Muslim said, and there is much that is similar to what we have mentioned of the words of the people of knowledge concerning accused narrators of hadith, and the faults in their reports, for which we have no room to write about here. What we have mentioned is sufficient for those who are wise and understand the way of the muhaddithin in discussing and explaining such matters. The reason why they oblige themselves to expose the faults of the narrators of hadith and transmitters of reports, and to pass judgment on them when asked to, is due to the seriousness of the matter. Reports on matters of religion speak of lawful and unlawful, commands and prohibitions, exhortation and warning. If the narrator is not sincere and honest, and the one who knows of his faults hears it and narrates it without explaining his faults to one who is unaware of them, then he will be sinning if he does that, betraying the common folk of the Muslims. For he cannot be certain that some of those who hear those reports will not follow and accept them, or some of them, although they, or most of them, are lies that have no basis. Moreover, the authentic reports, which are narrated from trustworthy narrators and the people who are accepted, are so great in number that there is no need to quote from narrators that are not trustworthy and not accepted. I think that the reason why most of the people of this type narrate these weak ahadith and chains of unknown narrators and accept them after knowing of their faults is to show how much knowledge of hadith they have before the masses, and so that it will be said, how many ahadith so-and-so has memorized and recorded. Whoever follows such a path with knowledge, then he has no share of true knowledge, and it is more befitting that he should be called ignorant rather than knowledgeable.